And here on 4029 News on the Record, we're joined by Laurie Lee, the chairman of the Reform Alliance. And Laurie, tell us a little bit about what your organization does. I know that you do support school choice.
Yes, so our organization has been in operation for almost a decade. We advocate for and administer the state's two choice programs that exist already, the Succeed Scholarship, which is a voucher for special needs kids, foster children, and children of military dependents, and then also the Philanthropic Investment Act in Arkansas Kids, which is a tax credit scholarship for kids who are 200% of the poverty level or below in the state of Arkansas, which is funded by tax credits from businesses or persons in the state of Arkansas that owe state income tax.
Okay, so let's talk about those programs in just a little bit with those scholarships. The governor has been a big advocate for school choice. What are your thoughts on what she is thinking, and what do legislators need to do?
So our thoughts are we're extremely excited to have a governor who is so laser focused on education, making sure that our teachers are paid adequately and that they are empowered in the classroom, and that families will have access to their education dollars to be able to take their kids and put them in education models that work best for their children.
So what are those education models? Are you talking about online study or all the way to private education?
So it would be, it could be in anything. Like for instance, in the state of Arizona, their ESA program allows for any model of learning. You can do a traditional public school, you can do homeschool, you can do private school, you can do micro schools. There's so many options available to families now in 2023 or any combination thereof. It really is now where parents can kind of put together their child's educational journey or what is the best thing that fits their child's specific needs.
So in your opinion, you think that maybe some of that money should go to parents to send their kids to even private schools of their choice?
Oh, of course, yes, we advocate for that, yes. And the data and the science proves that when states have robust school choice programs like Florida, Arizona, Indiana, now places like West Virginia, that it actually lifts all boats. Mm-hmm. Because the kids that are in traditional public schools now that tend to struggle, or maybe that model doesn't fit, they are able to seek out models that better fit their specific needs, whether that be, like I said, a private school. They can use the money for tutoring or therapies. In the case of Arizona, they can even use this money to partner with their traditional public school to include paying for classes or services or extracurricular activities at that traditional public school. So the public schools will actually be a benefactor of a program like this as well.
Okay, well, what do you say to those who say, well, private schools are not as regulated, so that's really not a good idea?
So I would say to them that private schools are regulated. They are regulated by parents. They are regulated by some legislation, they are accountable. And so the thing that that happens is that when a child attends a private school, if that private school is not serving that child's needs, that parent can move. Unfortunately, in our traditional public school system, especially for our most vulnerable populations and our most financially struggling families, they're not able to do that. If you live in a school district that is a failing school or even a great school, and your child is not able to thrive in that school, then you're stuck there. There's nothing you can do. So the target of these programs is for families who don't have the options that some families have in the state of Arkansas that can put their kids in a private school. Say if your child is a special needs child, the schools are required to, by law, to provide programs and services for SPED kids. But we know in a lot of places that doesn't happen. They don't have the resources, they don't have the teachers. There's a lot of different things that happen in public schools that, because of their limited resources, they're not able to facilitate.
How would something like a school choice help those parents get their child from one school to another that may not be in their direct district because of transportation issues?
So that's a great question. And I'll reference the Arizona plan again. Transportation is provided for. So a family can use the money for transportation. You can get a commuter pass. You can, you know, use a taxi service or ride sharing. In some areas, they have put together a private bus line, if you will. It actually opens the door for a lot of innovation and economic stimulus in places that don't have those services right now. So, but some of those dollars would be able to be used under the law for the ESA to use for transportation.
All right, Laurie Lee, thank you so much for joining us on talking about school issue. We're gonna be back in 2 minutes to talk more about school choice and also an event that's coming up. Welcome back here to 4029 News on the Record. We are here with Laurie Lee with the Reform Alliance talking about school choice, and you have an event that's coming up that you're a part of, Laurie, on Monday. Tell us about that.
So on Monday, the 23rd, we have our National School Choice Week rally at the State House Convention Center. It starts at 11, and we have invited parents and teachers and students from across the state to come and attend. Governor Huckabee Sanders will be there. Also, Corey DeAngelis, who is a national education choice person who studies the issue. We've right now probably got around 1,000 students, teachers, and parents that will be there. We're very excited for this and everybody around the state. If you would like to come, you can contact our office and we can either help get transportation for you to the rally, or we can reimburse for transportation for groups also.
All right, and that is in correspondence with the National School Choice Week, is that correct?
That's correct. National School Choice Week happens every year, the last week of January. We do have other events across the state. If folks are interested, they can go to our Facebook page and go to our events page. And we have events in Jonesboro, Forest City, Blytheville, Batesville, they're all over the state.
All right, and real quickly, can you talk a little bit more about those two scholarship programs that are related to school choice that your organization does?
Sure, great. So, and I would encourage your watchers to contact the Reform Alliance. We have the Philanthropic Investment Act. It is a scholarship account that is funded by tax credits. The people that get the scholarships aren't the ones that get the tax credits necessarily, but anybody, any family that is 200% of the poverty level or below, which works out to be about $55,000 annually for a family of four, mm-hmm. can apply for the scholarship, and we do have room in that scholarship left. Okay. And so it is for tuition and fees for a private school. Okay. The Succeed Scholarship is a voucher that is for kids with disabilities, children, foster children, and children of military dependents. That is also for private school tuition and fees. That window is closed right now, but will reopen sometime in the summer. And both of those scholarships are worth somewhere between $6,000 and $7,800 annually. So they cover the average tuition in private schools across the state of Arkansas.
All right, Laurie Lee with the Reform Alliance. Laurie, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us today here on 4029 News on the Record.
Thank you very much, and we hope that all your folks will visit our webpage or give us a call if they want more information.
Thank you.